Hey there, Jeremy Goodrich here, the owner of Shine Insurance Agency, real estate insurance superhero. And really, that is my specialty, real estate insurance. And so I'm going to put my headphones on here first so I can hear. There we go, much better. And I'm going to go through what you just downloaded. Thank you so much for opting into the complete guide to REI Insurance. A lot of the folks I talk to who are right where you're at are basically saying, I don't know what's going on. I've got 10 properties. Insurance is all over the place. I've always seen insurance as just kind of this thing that I have to deal with. And at the same time, I realize that if I need it, I really want it to be there. And I just want to understand it. And so we've created a guide for you that is going to solve that problem. I'm going to take about 5 minutes here to go over the guide, and then you can walk through it and take care of it yourself. So you have two parts of this guide that were delivered in the email. The first is sort of this Excel document. And I left it in Excel because I just know how we all like to manipulate numbers. It didn't make any sense to sort of control the formatting. In fact, if you want some different kind of version, reach out to me and let me know. We'll share an Airtable or Google Drive document or something like that. More than happy to do that. But basically, there's this Excel document here, and it is the exact same document that I provide to every investment property owner I work with. Some of these folks have 800, 900 units that they have on their schedule. So obviously it's a lot bigger than this, but it's laid out in the exact same way, the way that I've laid it out here for you. Now this one is an example. What I would do is get rid of stuff and put your own things in there. And so the guidebook then, so you have the organizer. That's really where you're going to put your information. The guidebook is here to help you understand that information. So as you scroll down, page one is a little bit about Shine, a little bit about me, just so you know. Page two obviously is a table of contents, and then it talks about the organizer, the thing I just described there, and then it gets right into the A, B, C, D explanations of this organizer. You'll notice that top bar, the teal bar, has four different sections of it: the property information, coverages, limitations, and details. Those four sections of the organizer are broken down here in the same way as A, B, C, D sections. Pretty cool, right? Each section has some meaning. So let's talk about it quickly. The first one is property information. One of the biggest mistakes that folks make when they're dealing with anything around a larger scale of investment properties is forgetting properties. Getting some property lost, you know, whether that's in your tax work that you're doing or your lawyer stuff or your leases or certainly taking care of tenants or collecting money. And insurance is one of those things too. And so the first section of our organizer is all about the properties, and we set that out there. So one insurance nerd thing to understand is these first two sections: location and building. Oftentimes, a location has multiple buildings on it. If it is one deeded property with three different buildings, all of which have eight units of apartments, then you're going to have location one, building one, location one, building two, location one, building three. So you can certainly have one location with two, five, 10 buildings on that same location. If you have a separate deeded property, then you're going to have a separate location. So lots of times we'll just have single family homes, a schedule of 30 single family homes, and it's going to be location one, building one, location two, building one, location three, building one. There's just one building at each location. That's very common. But understanding location and building is a super insurance nerd thing to understand, because that is how policies are set up and how you'll need to understand how things are working in the system. And so as you're putting things in there, think to yourself, well, at this location, how many buildings are there? And put those down there. So sometimes you could have the same address three times in a row, maybe with an A, B, C, D, or maybe not any different address at all. It's just three different buildings at that same place. So understanding location and building number is super important and digs right into insurance nerd. Address needs no description. This is just the address. Square footage is in here because so many insurance things are based off of square footage that I think it's important to have it. There are lots of other details that are important as well, but I think square footage is one of the most important details as far as what's driving many of the coverage choices on your policy. So we decided in the property information section to have location number, building number, address, and then square feet, as well as occupancy, what it's there for. Is it a single family home? Is it a duplex? Is it a threeplex? So on and so forth. I didn't put that on here, but you'll see that that is in the overview. All right, so then we get to the insurance coverages. This is section B, and this is what the coverages are. And there's really four basic coverages that are in this section. The first is the most important, the building coverage. This is if the building, you know, burns down, what coverage do we have to replace that building? You should figure that at around $125 a square foot, depending on where you're at in the country, in the world. That can obviously vary, but this building coverage is right there. Business personal property is the next one. This is the stuff inside the property that you own. If you're an annual, if you have annual tenants in your space, there's probably not very much. Maybe $3,000. It's just the fridge, the stove, maybe a washer and dryer. The next one is business income. This is sometimes called loss of income. This is how much you make off that property in a given year. That's the number you should use for this coverage. And you're going to put that right there so that if you aren't able to make money off that property because of a covered loss, your insurance company could pay you back as a part of that process. And then finally, general liability coverage, which I put down on this organizer kind of by itself, but super important coverage. This is coverage for bad things that happen to other people because of you. So really four sections of this, the main coverages that you have on your policy: building coverage, business personal property coverage, loss of income or business income coverage, and general liability. Those are in the coverage sections, with general liability kind of being out here by itself. And the reason it's out by itself is oftentimes general liability coverage is policy level. So it'll be per policy, not per property. And so you can't really put it on each property because it's per policy. That's not always the case, but that's how it's set up here. All right, we hanging in there so far? Only two more sections to go. Limitations. This is things that limit your coverage. There are multiple limitations. In fact, your building coverage itself is a limitation, but these are some more common ones. And I'm not going to go into the weeds on all these. We have videos on every single one of them. But coinsurance is important to understand and know. The perils that this is insured against, what kinds of bad things are covered by your policy. Different policies cover different bad things. And do you have a basic, broad, or special policy? Your deductible, which is you saying, hey, I'll take on the first $1,000 of a loss before the insurance company gets involved, or $5,000 or $10,000. I have clients who keep $25,000 deductibles. Your deductible is a great way to control the cost of the insurance policy by saying how much you will take on of the risk before the insurance company has to get involved. And the last thing on here is exclusions, which is super important, not in the portfolio overview, but in exclusions are definitely good to understand, at least at the surface level. There are lots of exclusions, and most of them make sense when you really dig into them. But understanding exclusions is important. So that's the limitations section C. And then finally, section D is just kind of the policy details, some of the things you need to know. So what's the policy number? You know, if you're calling the insurance company, you know what the policy is. What company are you even calling? What company is this with? You know, are there lenders on properties? And if so, which lenders are they? And then finally, most important part is really the premium. How much does it cost total, and how much does it cost per property? So there you go. Those are the sections. And then I added a few pages into this booklet just to give you some last overview. What are some of those gotcha extras, things that people, insurance companies don't include and insurance agents will exclude so they can make their policy look a lot cheaper, but maybe you really want to have? I've put a list of those kinds of things. Maybe you want them, maybe you don't. But I put a list in here so you could check off the ones that you have and understand the ones that you don't and whether you need them or not. So that's the gotcha extras page. And then if you want to know how to shop for the right insurance agent, I've created a page here as well. You know, it's like five steps to finding a really good agent who's going to take great care of you, be an advisor for you, and really help you to understand insurance and find the best insurance policy. So that's there. And then finally, a little bit about if you do want to connect with Shine, if you'd like us to be your insurance agent, we'd be more than happy to consider that and have a conversation and talk through it. So that's the last page here. All right. So that is the complete guide to REI Insurance. I hope that you feel as you walk through this, that you understand it better, that you have a grounding in your real estate investing insurance. And as you put all your properties into the portfolio organizer, you use this over and over again to help you make sure you've got insurance right. I tell you what, if you go to a good insurance agent and provide them with an organizer like this, with all your properties set up into it, their eyes are going to light up. And they're going to be like, oh my gosh, wow, this person really knows what they're talking about and they really are organized about their property. So I hope this is helpful. I hope it takes you down to the road to financial freedom faster. I hope you find a insurance agent, an insurance advisor who becomes a true part of your service team and makes you helps you to make more money over the course of time. Really appreciate you downloading these resources. If you have any questions, please let us know. You can go to shineinsurance.com and check in with us. All right, until the next time, have a wonderful day.